All right, the Philippine government preparing for a worst-case scenario as Super Typhoon Pepito approaches landmass. According to the Office of Civil Defense, about 10 million people could be affected by Pepito's onslaught. OCD Executive Director Undersecretary Ariel Nepomuceno says more than 13,000 personnel have been deployed, including hundreds of search and rescue teams. Meanwhile, even as government prepares for the storm, it continues to serve and provide supplies to more than 35,000 individuals affected by recent typhoons that are still in evacuation centers.
Tapos na dapat tayo din sa paghuhulaan o naintindihan natin, umaasa tayo na sana malusaw yung bagyo, sana wag dumaan, sana hindi malakas yung ulan na dala, tigil na po natin doon. Doon tayo mapapahamak. Mas maganda, bago dapat ang ating attitude, doon tayo siya tinatawag na paghahanda doon sa posibleng pinakamalalang posibilidad na epekto ng bagyo.
Interior Secretary John Vicremulla is calling on local government units in Metro Manila and affected provinces to prepare for possible storm surges caused by Pepito. Remulla warns residents in low-lying communities and coastal areas to evacuate immediately. The secretary underscored the importance of moving inland since storm surges could reach as high as 5 to 7 meters. The Philippine Health Department raises code white alert in preparation for the potential impact of Super Typhoon Pepito. Under this alert, health personnel and staff in public hospitals are on standby to provide prompt medical assistance to those affected by the typhoon. Regions such as Metro Manila, Bicol, and Eastern Visayas have also declared a code white alert as part of emergency measures. The DOH urging the public, especially vulnerable groups and residents in high-risk areas, to prepare emergency kits and evacuate early to ensure their safety. A potentially devastating scenario looms for Bicol region in the Philippines due to Super Typhoon Pepito, the storm internationally known as Manny. Further intensified this Saturday afternoon, it now packs 195 kilometers per hour peak winds and gusts of up to 240 kilometers per hour. Now, the storm was last seen at 145 kilometers east-northeast of Catarman in northern Samar. The rare tropical cyclone wind signal number 5 has been raised in Catanduanes province. Per the Weather Bureau, this meant a very intense typhoon will affect the area with heavy damage even to low-risk structures. Pagasa says evacuation of locals in the province should be completed by now, as it warned any time later would be too late. A landfall is expected tonight or early Sunday morning. Other areas in Bicol region are now under signal number 4, namely the northeastern portion of Camarines Sur and the northeastern portion of Albay. Meanwhile, signal number 2 is up in Metro Manila and neighboring regions, Calabarzon and Central Luzon. Meteorologists worldwide note the unusual stream of storms that have ravaged the Philippines in the last 4 weeks. A local meteorologist warns pre-developing La Niña conditions play a role in the inclement weather. Details in this report.
In just 4 weeks, 6 cyclones have battered the Philippines. The string of storms began with severe tropical storm Christine, which entered the Philippine area of responsibility on October 20. Over 3.3 million Filipinos were affected by Christine. Barely a day after Christine's onslaught, Leon entered the PAR and quickly intensified as a super typhoon. Philippine disaster officials estimate around 150 people were killed in the onslaught of the back-to-back storms. 2 more storms entered the PAR in the first week of November. Typhoon Marce rapidly intensified before making landfall near Santa Ana, Cagayan on November 7th. It exited PAR a day after, but not before wreaking havoc in northern Luzon. Typhoon Nika followed days after, prompting the evacuation of some 32,000 Filipinos living in vulnerable areas. A United Nations assessment of the past month's weather disasters found the string of storms have damaged over 207,000 homes, displaced nearly 700,000 people. NASA's Deep Space Climate Satellite also spotted the 4 most recent cyclones near the Philippines. The satellite image shows tropical cyclones Marce, Nika, Ophel, and Pepito lining up in the western Pacific. NASA notes the oddity of the four storms churned together. According to the Japan Meteorological Agency, this is the first time so many storms coexisted in the Pacific Basin in November since records began in 1951. Meanwhile, the UP Resilience Institute and NOAA Center, which has mapped out flood-prone areas in the country, advises four provinces to be on alert for heavy flooding due to Pepito. They also urge the public to check their website, noaa.up.edu.ph, to see which areas will be severely flooded and which places they can evacuate.
According to the forecast, these places, Albay, Catanduanes, Sorsogon, and Northern Samar, are the ones expected to have intense to torrential rainfall. But of course, the distribution of the rainfall will be uneven and the floods will happen not everywhere, but in places where the water can flow with least resistance.
The Philippine province of Ilocos Sur seeks additional aid for residents who could be affected by Super Typhoon Pepito. Disaster response officials say supplies are running out after the string of storms that hit the province in recent weeks. There are no evacuation orders yet, but authorities gave their assurance they are ready to relocate residents if necessary.
Siyempre, tuloy-tuloy ang pagbibigay natin ng mga ayuda. Siyempre na de-deplete na din yung ating mga stockpiling. Lalo yung budget natin ay hindi rin kalakihan. Kami din sa province ay nagre-request na din sa regional office dito sa Region 1 ng mga augmentation. So far may mga konti na lang and kung may magbibigay ng additional augmentation from the region or from the national, better po para at least makapaghandaan namin ang epekto ng Pepito po.
The province of Isabela has yet to see the effects of Super Typhoon Pepito. According to the local disaster office, the weather remains clear. However, they continue to deal with the impact of previous storms. Two electric cooperatives are still trying to restore power lines damaged by severe tropical storm Nika. Disaster officials also downgraded their alert status from red to blue to allow the responders time to rest and even prepare for Pepito. Now, authorities also say they still have enough quick response funds.
Our quick response fund is still intact because we have not placed the province in a state of calamity this year. So we have sufficient funds to respond to whatever we need to respond to. Right now, we have reset our monitoring response and relief.
The province of Apayao bracing for the expected onslaught of Super Typhoon Pepito. The local disaster management office says displaced residents have temporarily returned to their homes to repair the damage caused by Storm Ophel. Strong winds have battered the province, causing roofs to be torn off and power outages in several areas. But the local government says it is prepared to evacuate residents again, if necessary, as Pepito approaches.
Ready naman po sila and ready po ang mga nakapreposition din po na food. Sa ngayon po, close po muna ang evacuation center pero mag-open po ulit pag meron na naman po tayong may raise na signal and lalo-lalo na po sa mga nasa front areas. Kasi balikan mo po muna sila para ayusin po ang kanilang mga bahay-bahayan.
The provincial government of Northern Samar assures the public it is prepared for the impact of Typhoon Pepito. Disaster officials there say they already ordered a preemptive evacuation in the affected municipalities. Now, as of today, there are already around 20,000 evacuees in the area.
We always consider naman yung social distancing pa rin kahit wala ng COVID for health reasons, no? It's always integrated in our policy sa mga evacuation centers. Ang buong probinsya at national government ay nag-preposition naman ng sapat na pagkain for this evacuees. No? Mga around 50,000 food packs. So wala rin pong problema dito. May mga modular tents kami. No? Wala pa nung COVID-19 pandemics. Hanggang ngayon, practice na yan ng mga evacuation centers natin.
A curfew is now in effect in Naga City in Camarines Sur in anticipation of Super Typhoon Pepito's wrath. The local government says locals are required to stay in their homes or in evacuation centers for safety. Private establishments also told to suspend operations while the curfew is in effect. Operations of vehicles, except those used for essential services and for emergency response, are also prohibited. Several flights, mostly going to the Bicol region, suspended due to Super Typhoon Pepito, which is expected to make landfall over Catanduanes as early as Saturday night. Here's the list. Telco firms also bracing for Pepito's impact. Globe Telecom in a statement said teams and equipment are on standby in southern and central Luzon as well as in eastern Visayas. The telco company also assured customers its network facilities have gensets in the event of power outages. PLDT also giving the assurance it's augmenting its pre-positioned teams and resources in the aftermath of Typhoon Ophel and with the expected impact of Pepito. The Philippine government assures the public fuel supply remains sufficient in the Ilocos region, Cagayan Valley, and Cordillera, despite consecutive typhoons. The Task Force on Energy Resiliency reports no oil supply disruptions, with all bulk facilities operational except for three retail outlets. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. has directed government agencies to ensure adequate supplies of fuel, power, and other essentials for typhoon-hit communities. A 15-day price freeze on household LPG cylinders and kerosene also in effect following the declaration of a state of calamity in Cabagan, Isabela, Dilasag, Aurora, and Paracelis in Mountain Province. The November 17 show of the Grand Biniverse concert has been rescheduled to a later date due to the anticipated bad weather from Super Typhoon Pepito. In a statement, Star Music said the Sunday show will be moved to Tuesday, that's November 19, to ensure everyone's safety. Those who will be unable to attend the show on the new date can also ask for a refund. Passes for the live stream of the concert on the affected date will also be valid for the rescheduled show on Tuesday. Meanwhile, the Grand Biniverse concerts on Saturday and Monday will proceed as planned. Part of the proceeds from the Grand Biniverse concert will be donated to the ABS-CBN Foundation to help stone victims.